It's the day after Thanksgiving, and I woke up this morning still with gratefulness in my heart. gratefulness for my family and gratefulness for a lot of things in my life. The church that I get to labor for, and my friends that popped up through the day to say happy Thanksgiving, and it was just a good day. But this morning, the gratefulness that I woke up with was a gratefulness for Jesus in my heart. It's a different kind of gratefulness, I guess. It's a kind that comes from knowing that I have a secure future and I have a hope for my future. And regardless of what the circumstances look like, I get to hope in that. Peter wrote about it in 1 Peter 1. And it's verse 3-6, he said, "Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. According to his great mercy, he has caused us to be born again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you who by God's power are being guarded through faith for his salvation ready to be revealed in the future. In the last time, in this you rejoice, though now for a little while, if necessary, you have been grieved by various trials, so that the tested genuineness of your faith, more precious than gold that perishes though it is tested by fire, may be found to be a result in praise and glory and honor to the revelation of Jesus Christ. Though you have not seen him, you love him. Though you do not see him, you believe in him and rejoice with joy that is inexpressible and filled with glory, obtaining the outcome of your faith, the salvation of your souls." I remember a quote that actually Scott Cairns told me about. Timothy Keller talked about what hope is for a Christian. We use the word hope a lot, right? I hope I get that job, or I hope I get that house, or I hope I get this or that. But for a Christian, Timothy Keller said, biblical hope is a little bit different, that it's being certain about a future in such a way that it affects your living now. And we're headed into the Advent season, into a season of hope for Christians, because we know who's coming and we know that Jesus is coming. And the reason we hope is not because this little baby is born. The reason we hope is because when this little baby was born, it set into motion the salvation of our souls. He came knowing that he was going to die on a cross for us so that we could have salvation, so that we could be put right together with God. So I want to encourage you this morning to allow your heart to be filled with biblical hope, a certainty that you know what your future is and that it affects how you live right now. And I want to invite you to join us for our Advent series that's starting this Sunday in person at Marco Presbyterian Church. If you're watching us online, you'll get to see an amazing message about the last message for our Generous Life series. But if you want to join us in person, you can do that safely. We're all wearing masks. We are social distanced, and you don't have to touch any doorknobs. There's hand sanitizer everywhere, so you can come safely and join us for worship and hear about the dawn of hope, the hope that saves the world, not a hope that's wishful thinking, but a hope that is certain about a future outcome, the one where we get to live forever with our God in heaven.